Scampi is now considered as a pretty cheap and nasty ingredient. But how many people know that scampi is actually this, langoustine? So what I want to do is take this and turn it into my ultimate scampi fry.
On the continent, langoustine tails are one of the most prized seafoods, but us Brits just don't seem to be interested. I start by removing the plump langoustine tail. The tail meat is chopped and mixed with sweet preserved lemons.
So there's the main part of my filling. But inside of that, I'm going to one of these. It's a soft boiled quail's egg. So the idea is when my guests bite into the scampi stuffing, they'll get this wonderful warm liquid yolk mixed with the scampi. Something they're not going to be expecting. Certainly not the scampi fry anyway.
And for some real luxury, I'm surrounding my mini egg with wafer thin slices of white truffle.
What I'm now going to do is turn it into my ultimate scampi fry. And in order to do that, I am going to need some proper scampi fries.
I'm going to use the blitzed crumbs from actual scampi fries to create a uniquely fishy crumb coating. This gives a perfect crisp texture once deep fried.
So here is an original scampi fry, and here is my ultimate scampi fry.
To top it off, I need to recreate that dinky half pint of shandy I remember so fondly. A langoustine and tomato consommé forms my shandy base.
Obviously, every beer needs a head, needs a throat.
And I'm using aerated celery froth.
So here is my ultimate scampi fry and my ultimate scampi fry beer. Cheers.